moving on from Rode Heath. The weather this morning is a bit of a contrast to yesterday evening when it was nice and sunny. Today it's wet, windy and chilly. Wonderful British summer. See what the day brings. Thank you.
No worries,
so I'll let Jeffy, because I've got the boat to come up. Oh, okay. We're going to go out and he'll come in, so. Yeah, cheers. Yeah, cut it for us now, would you? Yeah. I don't know. Are you walking? Oh yeah, where the volunteers are. Heath, pleasant part of the canal actually. Lots of properties got nice canal side frontage. The sky's looking threatening though. I think it's going to pour the rain again in a minute. Well, pleasant place to sit and watch the world go round. This is a set of locks that yesterday was covered with an army of volunteers painting, and it does all look very smart. Two boats coming up through this set of locks from the other direction now. That's a grand old wooden one. Morning. Hello. So, are you getting on? I don't know what the story was with those two old boats. Both wooden. Did you see those two boats? They were both wooden ones. Nice farmyard smells here. Mind your head. So, lot 55, one of several lots we've got to do today. So the boat that went up left these next set of lock gates open for me, so I can go from one lock to the other without having to stop and open and close gates. Well, that was the famous lot 57 that had been broken for 2 weeks. It just came through, and then the rain came, and I had to put the camera away because it was getting wet. Now we're going into the next lot, and it's right next to the busy M6, which has got phenomenal amount of traffic on it. And the rain stopped, but we're absolutely drenched because it was a 10-minute downpour that came down in bucketfuls. Never mind. Continue our journey, and as we got to the lock, which is lock number 57, the skies opened and it threw bucketfuls of water down, and we got absolutely drenched and soaked to the skin. So I decided that I'd had enough for one day, even though I'd only done a couple of locks, and as soon as I found a suitable place to moor, I'd stop for the day, which I've done. And as you can see from the panoramic view I've just done, the M6 is in the far distance. We can't hear it, so I guess the wind's blowing in the right direction. Anyway, I banged the pins into the bank to moor the boat up, and then the next thing I know, I'm surrounded by literally thousands of wasps. So I disturbed a wasp nest. And one of the little stung me right there on the tip of my nose, and they were all around me, on my glasses, in my hat, everywhere. So I'm dancing up and down the towpath, and I had to wait 10 minutes for it all to calm down before I could pull the mooring pin back out and move the boat a few hundred yards up the canal. So that was it. That's it for the day. I'm now having a couple of drinks. The rain stopped. It's a nice blue sky. And I'm sorry if I'm waffling on, but I've got to tell you that story. Catch you later.